So the Torah portion of Vayakhel-Pekudei, I think, are the first parashiyot since the beginning, since Bereshit, which are somewhat censored, or perhaps would even have to be rated X, if you like, and I will explain. So reading Vayakhel-Pekudei, the first thing that one notices is the lack of Rashi. There are many verses, right? We're rectifying here, we're building the Mishkan, and in all the verses that talk about specifically how to create the Mishkan, the measurements, right, psukim that seem, you know, quite simple and easy to follow, Rashi is silent. Rashi has nothing to tell us. Now, why is this odd? Because we are told, Rashi tells us, that what is his role? To explain the pshat of the Torah. What does that mean? To explain the simple meaning. In Bereshit, when God creates the world in a very complicated manner, Rashi's all over the place explaining the simple meaning of God creating the world. And yet here, in Vayakhel-Pekudei, wherever we learn about the exact dimensions and the doings, the creating of the Mishkan, things that seem simple, Rashi is silent. What is the secret that is being hidden from us? What is going on here that is there is censorship? The real story is not being told to us in Vayakhel-Pekudei. What is it? The only thing that I can come about, that I can come to when I read Vayakhel-Pekudei, is that there are many underlying emotions in Vayakhel-Pekudei in the building of the Mishkan. There is deep desire and burning passion. And we see it throughout the entire parsha. It begins when Moshe calls all of Bnei Israel and tells them, right, you can bring a truma, nedava, to contribute to creating the Mishkan. We are told that all of Bnei Israel heard this. Right, call it that in Israel. However, when we're told when they come back, what began with call it that in Israel becomes Vayavo kol ish asher naso libo v'chol asher nadavar cho. Not all of that in Israel came back to bring truma, only all those who had a spirit of wanting to volunteer. Something is going on in the camp, and not everyone is coming to help. Some emotional battle. I don't know what it is. And then we are told, "Vayavohu ha'anashim al hanashim." The men come on top of the women. I don't know what that means. According to Rashi, he says that the women came side by side together to bring stuff. But the pshat sounds a little bit odd. And I'm not even going to get into the kind of jewelry that Bnei Israel brought. I'll leave those juicy parts for you. We are then told that this burning desire is so great, right? Those who came to bring the gifts to build the Mishkan, they didn't stop. They brought so much that the Kablanim, Eliav and Bezalel, had to tell Moshe, please fend them off. They're not stopping to bring gifts. This burning passion to bring gifts. And what does Moshe have to do? He says, Kol v'yitzav Moshe v'yaviru kol b'machane. He's creating billboards on that very day, billboards throughout the entire camp of hundreds of thousands, and he's telling them, people, stop bringing gifts. And the words that are used are Vayikaleh am havi. The people were restrained, almost imprisoned, from bringing gifts, right? So there's a great burning passion and desire which comes together with these great technical details, this parshia of building the Mishkan. The peak, of course, the peak of this emotional battle is the building of the sink, the basin, the kior. As you know, all of the stuff, the things that were created for the Mishkan, they all are rectangular, right? And they all have their specific measurements, except for the basin, except for the kior, where the Kohanim came to wash their hands and feet before they did the holy work. This is the only thing which we are not told its dimensions, which I think is very telling, and I'll get to that in a moment. And we are told that it was created by marot tzovot, by mirrors. Now, what are these mirrors? Rashi tells us that Moshe, when he saw the women bringing their mirrors, which they used to, beautify themselves, perhaps also the men, Moshe didn't want to accept this. He said, "How can you use these mirrors? This is yetzer hara. This is the sign of bad desire. We can't possibly be using this." And Hashem says to Moshe, Kabel, relax, accept those gifts. Because that same Yetzer Hara, the bad that you see in those mirrors, I see the good. Thanks to those mirrors, back in Egypt, when the men were weak, after a long day's work, they couldn't think of pur vu, of bringing the next generation. The women preened themselves and showed themselves to the males, hence awakening them. And it is thanks to those women and those mirrors, that Yetzer HaTov, that desire which was turned to a good thing, that I had legions, tzva'ot, of Bnei Israel to take out of Egypt. And I think that's the point. The basin, the sink, which has no dimensions. Because Yetzer Hara and Yetzer HaTov have no dimensions, they have no beginning and they have no end. That, I think, is what Vayakhel-Pekudei is all about. The underlying thing that is going on here, the creating the Mishkan, if you like, I think that Vayakhel-Pekudei is the Song of Songs, Shir HaShirim of the Torah, for Hashem and the relationship between Hashem and Bnei Israel, and the battle between Yetzer HaTov and Yetzer Hara, and how to turn our desires into the right places. Shabbat Shalom.